I'm Rosa Bojani, and will give a presentation about multi-message astronomy and the training of the future generation of astrophysicists. Multi-message astronomy is the combination of the information coming from different astronomy, the astronomy in the electromagnetic domain, optical, radio, infrared, ultraviolet, X-rays, and gamma rays, astronomy with cosmic rays, astronomy with neutrinos, astronomy with gravitational waves, and the dark matter search. The variety of multi-message in astronomy is well described by the broad range of instruments and techniques. In the first line, we recognize a telescope and an array radio telescope. In the center line, we recognize an high-energy astrophysics mission and the Cherenkov telescope. And in the bottom, you will find the IceCube detector and the one of the LIGO detector. Multi-message astronomy can be very well described by two recent cases. One is the first detection of a binary neutron star merger, GW170817, who has been accompanied by the short gamma ray burst 1708 17A, just about 2 seconds after the merger. Here, it is shown the detection of the optical counterpart and of the X-ray of the radio counterpart. EC 170922A is the first IceCube neutrino, who has been associated to the blazar TXS 0506 plus 056, which has been observed both by Fermi and MAGIC. When dealing with teaching multi-messenger astronomy, we have to remind that astrophysics is not an experimental science, but an observational science. It is not possible just to improve statistics by repeated execution of the experiment. There is no control over the observing conditions. Our task is to teach the instrumentation, the observational techniques, and the data reduction techniques, and the techniques or analysis of each astronomy, going beyond the optical astronomy, which tradition has been dominant in observational astronomy teaching. In the present era, we are witnessing the birth of a new large telescope with an instrument and the birth of new energy observatories. And instrumentation building is at the forefront of science intersection of astrophysics technology and experimental physics. So our students must be prepared both for observational science, because they are dealing with astronomy, and also for experimental physics, because we are dealing with the building of instrument or the use of detectors. And overall, all students should learn how to plan astronomical observation, how to select the correct telescope or the instruments, how to perform observation, and how to reduce data and to interpret them. In all this process, they manage the flow of information in astrophysics, which includes images, spectra, and time series. And being able to analyze them is a kind of skill that holds for a broad range of careers. Today, astrophysicists provide a science driver for future facilities and are busy in the research and development of novel instrumentation. On the other hand, multi-message astrophysical observation become public very soon. Large facilities have large public archives, and in this sense, we can say these are open data, original research data, top quality and inclusive for everybody to be used in whatever part of the world without the need of observing, and are very suitable for in-class and online teaching, as has been demonstrated by the teaching during the pandemic. All experiments we propose must reproduce the research experience, both laboratory experiment and both data analysis and in-class labs. How do we achieve that? We try to propose experiment that just show different kind of astrophysical instrumentation, different kind of detectors. And in data analysis labs, we try to show the broad range of data that can be that are available over the whole electromagnetic spectrum and beyond. And this is the kind of labs that are computationally intensive. And today, basically, they are performed in Python. And in addition, just to be able to analyze and interpret data, we have to provide students with astrostatistics knowledge. I will describe you the experiment, the experience in teaching multi-messenger astronomy in Pisa at the Department of Physics, and I will describe my teaching approach about observation astrophysics. I will show you how I've been teaching multi-messenger astronomy both as a lab course, as lab courses with lab experiment and data analysis labs, and with an in-class traditional course, but with in-class analysis of open data. And in all that, all the different astronomy are considered research teams. Instead of presenting the detector, studying what we could measure, I start with these are the astrophysical sources, this is their spectral distribution, how could we measure this quantity. In this sense, astrophysics driving courses. From the point of view of experiment, I have devised some optical astronomy labs. Of course, we can perform telescope observation inside towns, but the sky is changing very much. And the sky is not so dark in towns, even in Galileo's town in Pisa. Another kind of experiment is the characterization of CCD, which is the instrument that students will find at big telescope. So just characterizing with bias frame and dark frames in the lab. And just speaking about the status of the sky, I have devised an experiment to measure the night sky brightness inside Pisa, just as a reference to the evolution of the sky background in astronomical observation. And there is also another experiment to understand the transparency of atmosphere to optical radiation. From the point of view of radio astronomy, I have devised both a bench experiment where students can test different components of radio astronomy receiver, antennas, voltage control oscillators, and so on. And then I decided some kind of receiving system to perform some observation, sun transit, solar flares, occur on meteors. A part of the experiment, the three leftmost pictures in the bottom line have been were investigating the emission at the frequency of hydrogen at 1,420 megahertz and the lower frequency. And also I have prepared a practical and easy and cheap experiment for doing observation with 10 gigahertz. And there is another kind of experiment, which is a real observational experiment with a loop antenna and some simple hardware software. Is it possible to perform a very low frequency detection of solar flare, which has a typical pattern show to the right? And students could check if a flare was occurring, comparing their observation with the GOES satellite results. From the pure high energy astrophysics, I have devised a different experiment. One is the cosmic ray detection system based on plastic scintillator and phototube, and another one is the observation of gamma rays, which is part of gamma ray astronomy, with an LSO scintillator and a new kind of photon sensor, the silicon photomultiplier, which is used very much also in astroparticle physics. And there is a more exotic experiment about the measurement of vibration, because the suspension system in LIGO Virgo are kind of oscillator. In this way, students can reproduce the kind of test that you perform with suspension interferometer, looking for normal modes of solids. Data analysis labs are cover basically a large part of electromagnetic spectrum. I've devised a data analysis lab about optical photometry spectroscopy of data secured at the professional telescope. This data analysis lab is interesting intrinsically, and also because the optical follow-up, especially spectroscopy, is important for understanding the kind of transient that could appear gravitationally or Tari energy. And another interesting aspect is the building of object catalogs when you're looking for transient. And I was asking also my student to write down the observer proposal for 1.5 meter aperture telescope, just to understand which are the correct order of magnitudes and to be prepared for what they will find during their PhD and future career. The high energy astrophysics section dealing about X-ray gamma ray astronomy is of course helped very much by the existence of open data archive. So in this way, I was able to propose the use of data from Chandra Swift, Fermilab, FermiGBM, just dealing with different kind of astrophysical sources: supernova remnant, blazar, gamma ray burst, X-ray binaries. And here you find the supernova remnant to the left, with morphology and with spectrum. To the right, you find the counterpart of the GW7087T binary neutron star merger. And there is also a data analysis lab about gravitational wave that's using the material prepared by LOSC in LIGO, which provides an interface just to deal with the gravitational wave time series. And in this way, students can reproduce the chirp of the events because data become public very soon. In conclusion, preparing the next generation of astrophysics for multi-method astronomy requires astrophysics-driven laboratory courses and class courses. And to provide them some training, both about instrumentation and both about data analysis. And of course, I have presented you my experience in dealing with topics. And this teaching approach, of course, is continuous appetite because multi-messenger astronomy is in continuous evolution. Thank you for your attention.